Hey everybody, I'm here in a new set of videos all about one of what I think is the most iconic design for a Windows computer. It's a Surface Pro 9. So this series of videos is all going to be about the tips and tricks for you to get the best out of this device. So let's get started. Okay, so Surface Pro 9. The Surface Pro range has been around for a number of years. But it reaches its pinnacle in the Surface Pro 9 that we see in front of us. And the design ethos, shall we say, of Surface Pro has always been about being around making the technology work the way that you want to, rather than you have to work in the way the technology was built. Now, let me explain that a bit further. So, it's about the way you work. So, we've got this amazing kickstand, which is really iconic. It's been around actually since the Surface Pro 3, but it means that we can angle that kickstand at any of the angles that we see there. So if I am working maybe at a desk like this, I might want that angle a bit higher up from a viewing perspective. If it was maybe a lecture or something like that, I may want to lower it down so I can speak to my audience a bit more. Or indeed, it may just be that I'm sitting at home on the sofa and I want to use the device and I want to angle it that way. So that's a great example of you or the technology working how you want it to do. Of course, we've got this amazingly iconic two-in-one design, which has really led a lot of the market in producing similar designs. So that two-in-one means my full compute kind of mode, and I've got my keyboard, which is magnetically latched up to the bottom of the screen there, so it's at an angle. Or I could choose maybe to have that keyboard absolutely flat, like I would do maybe here on this Surface Book. Of course, when we lay the keyboard flat, we expose the Surface Pen as well. But of course, when we want to get really mobile with the device, we would use tablet mode. And the way we get tablet mode is simply to detach the screen from the keyboard, and we are now in tablet mode. So I can now work on my device straight down, like so. I can take my Surface Pen and launch an application and really treat it as an absolute blank piece of paper. So here, rest my hand on that, make my notes. In a very natural way. I'm not doing any of this. It's up here and I've got my pen out here and I'm trying to write. It's as natural as, yep, that's gonna fold it down. That's gonna lay it down that way. Let's erase that and let's keep writing. Now notice when I am writing, I am actually just simply treating it as a normal piece of paper. So I've got my hand rested on, my palm is absolutely rested on the screen, and it's only picking up the pen nib. So this is what we call palm block, and really means that when you're using the Surface Pro in this tablet mode or pen mode, then you will be able to treat it as a natural, absolute natural writing experience. So, let's finish this video out with just a quick guide around there. So I'm just going to reconnect my keyboard to my screen, and you can see it's magnetic, so it automatically finds the keyboard. So top down camera. Let's get there. What we can see is a nice thin bezeled screen. So we've got a bigger real estate on the screen, which is a really sharp high definition screen. So we'll always get a really great picture. At the top there, we have an HD webcam and two microphones each side. So it's ideally positioned when I'm doing those kind of Teams calls to get the best quality recordings. Speakers in the side, along the bezel there as well, of course. If we shut the stand down, fold it over, we see our world-facing camera. So when we're in tablet mode, we can walk around, we can take photographs, take videos, use 3D modeling and things like that. Turn it over to this side, we see a Surface Connect charging port. And if I turn it around to this side, we have USB-C. Now you can always charge your Surface Pro device off a USB-C as long as it's developing the suitable amount of power to charge it, of course. So ideal if you've got a phone charger and you want to kick some life back into the device if you are caught short somewhere and you don't have your Surface Connect charger. On the next video, we'll take a look at Windows 11. We'll take a look at configuring the Surface Pen to make that environment really specific for you. See you on the next video.